Today, on You're Watching a Movie with Silas Lindenstein, I'm reviewing the new Jennifer Lopez sci-fi action movie, Atlas.
You're watching a movie with Silas Lindenstein in the theaters, you find this. So go on and press play and rewind this. This speech that is timeless. Love it like it or we lose it, can't find it. And we ain't keen on being reminded about the film if it isn't tough. We spend a lot of time at the cinema. It's just me and my friends, we watch plenty stuff. For movies, yeah, I've been above. Whether big or they small, no, for me don't make a difference. Love them. You're watching a movie with Silas Lindenstein in the theaters, you find this. So go on and press play and rewind this. This speech is timeless. Love it like it or we lose it, can't find it. And we ain't keen on being reminded about the film if it didn't hit. No, gotta lose it. Watch movies with my friends, bringing joy, that's the blueprint. So come on and let's do this. Leave pain behind us and relax your mind. Come watch a movie with Silas.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to You're Watching a Movie with Silas Lindenstein. I am your host, Silas Lindenstein. Today, I am reviewing the new Jennifer Lopez sci-fi film, Atlas. Atlas is PG-13, a sci-fi action film running 2 hours long. It's written by Leo Sardarian, Aaron Ellie Colliet, directed by Brad Peyton. The cast: Jennifer Lopez, Simu Liu, Sterling K. Brown, and Mark Strong. The story: a brilliant data analyst with a deep distrust of AI finds it may be her only hope when a mission to capture a renegade robot goes awry. So it's, she distrusts AI, but AI is her only hope. And then another description they had of it is, in a bleak-sounding future, an AI soldier has determined that the only way to end war is to end humanity. Nearly. That's kind of. But you don't know that for a while. Anyway, look, Atlas, it's a sci-fi film playing on Netflix. It's Netflix streaming today. It's the number one movie on Netflix. I don't know. Can't really. They just tell you, so you believe them. You don't know. It came out this last weekend, and I was immediately intrigued because I like Jennifer Lopez, you know, as a celebrity. I like stuff she's been in here and there. It's, you know, off and on films. Sometimes they're not my favorite. Sometimes they're good. Some aren't. But she's got enough name power and enough and she's interesting enough that I was like, really? She's doing this sci-fi AI robot thing? I mean, there was just another big Apple AI robot movie where, so kind of felt like, oh, did everyone just go to the studio with AI robots? Was that the thing the last couple of years to send those scripts over there? Everyone's gonna develop them and see which comes out and works. But I thought, oh, let give me a shot. And I don't know how you feel about Netflix films, because it's weird because Netflix, some, they put out some movies that are pretty good and really bad, right? And I said the same thing just moments ago about Jennifer Lopez. She does the same kind of movie. So I didn't know where this was going to fall. And I wanted to check it out, though, because I'm intrigued. You know, it's sci-fi. That's my thing. I want to get on this early. Maybe I will find a gem. Is Atlas a gem? I don't know. Maybe semi-precious? Not. It's not a, I don't know that it's a diamond. Look, it's got some good things. The special effects are astounding. They, like, it's better than a video game. You know, you're watching it and it's crazy, like, how good and real these, like, the major thing in the film is these mech, like, kind of mech suits. Like, soldiers get in these big giant suits and they can run around and control the arms and legs of it all and do everything inside of it. That's what's protecting her. In most of the film, she's inside of this mech suit protecting her on this planet. And it's so real, right? And that, it's astounding. The special effects are just wonderful on it. I think she does a good job with this character. I don't think the villain is that compelling. And I think that's the writing. You know, the Simu plays the villain of sort, the villain robot. And you know that because they tell you he is the villain robot, not because of things you really see. You don't really find out his motivations or much about him till near the end of the movie. Maybe some snippets beforehand, but I'm going to blame that on the script, because it didn't invest me into them. Like, Jennifer Lawrence's character, who is Atlas, can only be as exciting as her villain. And her villain wasn't fully developed, so I didn't fully understand. I didn't really care as much as I should. Now, Atlas has this background and does not trust AI, doesn't want to be involved with it. Like, all these soldiers have these little interfaces that kind of bridge the mind to a computer and connect them, and they go in sync, they call it. And she doesn't want to do that because she doesn't trust them. And they're kind of needed for these mech suits that she accidentally ends up in, and she needs to be to survive. And that's her internal struggle, like coming to terms with, is she going to use it to survive or what? And then not a relationship, but like a friendship she forms with the mech suit, who is in AI, which is one character named Smith. Smith is the voice we hear, and so it becomes like this computer voice, almost like if it was Star Trek and the computer on Star Trek, the voice was a character. I mean, it kind of was, but imagine it was interactive and responsive and talked to you the whole time. And it was actually a character driving you and challenging you. That's what it's kind of like. So that's the main, honestly, that's kind of the big relationship through most of it, is Smith and Atlas. So the human and the AI, who she doesn't trust. So, I mean, I think that is a good setup. I just don't think they delivered the way they should have. I'd say a great thing about the film is it's fun. I think it's super fun. It's, yeah, I mean, it's a fun watch. There's sci-fi films that you want to, that make you think. And some you have to just, you can't think too hard, or there's too many plot holes. There are too many things they didn't cover on how this happens. And maybe if it's a book, maybe the book gets into that detail and they didn't in the film. But you definitely have to sit back, turn your brain off a little, and just enjoy the ride, so to speak. Much like the character has to. But I do tend towards sci-fi that is more stimulating intellectually and for the brain. And I mean, this does bring up some interesting issues. I think this film would be more interesting to talk about than it is to actually watch, because it does raise ethics questions about the place of AI and how we treat them and how they would be good for us, how they could be bad for us or dangerous for us. And right now we're talking heavily about AI, right? But this is beyond AI. This is like taking AI and actually creating people, and then the machines, the robots are the AI. And I feel like what's happening right now in a lot of sci-fi films is they're saying we're combining the robot and AI into one thing. And I think you can have a robot that isn't like intelligent, right? But it's scarier that way, right? It's scarier than just like a box that the AI is in, like Siri and Alexa. They aren't very scary when you look at them. So we don't have that as the character. We got to throw it into something that can pick up a gun and shoot at you and make it all scary. Ooh. So it definitely does what it does well on playing off of your fears. So I think it'd be a good conversation piece kind of film. Then, and the worst parts of the film, as I mentioned, it's not very deep. It is the main character is underdeveloped. The main villain is underdeveloped, so it that hurts a bunch of the rooting for me of it. And I think it's somewhat of a forgettable film. I don't think it's a film that you're going to talk about much after it drops off the charts. It's going to kind of disappear. I don't know that the film has some staying power. And that's, I think, because not everything came together. It's pretty to look at, but there's not a lot of substance. Then, but yeah, and I wish I could interview Jennifer Lopez and find out what made her take this. I mean, she's clearly someone who can just turn stuff down or do it, what she was hoping to bring into this. Sterling K. Brown and Simu, yes, they're both upper level, like, actors. Simu probably star power is a little bigger right now. Sterling with the Oscars and all the nominations that he got probably is helping them a bunch. But I think there's still at points in their career that they can't turn too many things down. If it seems like a good project, sure. Yeah, let's do it. I have time. So, yeah. Look, this isn't one of the movies that I'm going to have a lot to say. I've delayed on this review a few days, right? So I've already seen comments, and I've heard some people say that, what an amazing film. It's so fun. And I've heard people say, that it's garbage. And I don't really ride on either side of that. I think it's a little bit more in the middle. I think the lessons that we want to take from Atlas, this film, 2024, I think it harkens on warnings about AI and what it means to protect humanity. I think that's where it succeeds a lot in science fiction, is it raises a lot of questions. It raises ethics questions that we're going to have and discussions. And I think if films do anything, that's what they should do. They should cause discussion. And for that, I gotta say the film is successful. It's gonna make me talk about things and talk about the world and our place in it. And it is, love it or hate it, you gotta love anything that gets you talking. You gotta like something that gets you talking, that gets people talking and engaging about a topic addressed in the film. So, bravo, you succeeded there. You just wish that discussion came in a package of something that was more resonant or had moments in the film that you really, really like. I guess some people really drew into the Smith character, the Smith voice, that really sucked them in, and the heartstrings got pulled because of the bond they built. I did not feel that. I get it, and I got the moments that they tried to create in it. I understood what they were going for. I don't think the majority of audiences are going to be sucked into that relationship of Jennifer Lopez and a voice. But I will say, I do appreciate, I got to say, the fact that this, no, it probably didn't pass the test, you know, the gender equity test out there. I'm forgetting the name of it right now. Because there's only really one significant character, Jennifer Lopez. But I do like the fact that she wasn't mooning over some dude the whole time, or like any of the time. It's nice to see female-led films that aren't stuck on, or the main issue isn't dealing with men in relationships. It was more of a protecting the earth and stopping one particular person who may be male, but is also a robot. So I don't know if they count as male. I don't think that counts. But anyway, I do appreciate that it wasn't Jennifer Lopez like in some sci-fi rom-com trying to save humanity, but also save her wedding date. You know, like I could have seen that in the 90s getting cast in something like that. So here's what I got to say. In my, you know, my rating system, love it, like it or lose it. Love it. It's a film that you can't stop talking about. You tell people they got to see right away. Like it is that broad spectrum of films that hit it with you for some reason and you connected with it and you'd watch it if it was on TV. And then lose it is I watched it so you don't have to. And I'm going to say Atlas, directed by Brad Peyton, gets a like it. The reasons being because it causes discussion, and that's what films exist for. Storytelling and discussion. And so it succeeded in what I think films are supposed to do. And I think that any time that you do that in a sci-fi film, in an explosive, action-packed film, an action film that gets you talking the points, has done a good job. But only as far as I like it goes. Okay? So that's it. Did you see the movie? It's streaming on Netflix. Exclusively on Netflix. Did you check it out? Do you agree or disagree? Comment below. Tell me what you thought of the film. Am I off base? Do I have it just right? Let me know. And I want to thank you for going ahead and subscribing so you can be notified the next time I drop a movie review or a discussion video. And I want to thank you for watching a movie with Silas Lindenstein.
You're watching a movie with Silas Lindenstein. In the theaters you find this. So go and press play and rewind this. This speech that is timeless. Love it, like it, or we lose it, can't find it. And we ain't keen on being reminded about the film if it isn't tough. We spend a lot of time at the cinema. It's just me and my friends, we watch plenty stuff. For movies, yeah, I've been above. Whether big or they small, no, for me don't make a difference, love. You're watching a movie with Silas Lindenstein. In the theaters you find this. So go and press play and rewind this. This speech it is timeless. Love it, like it, or we lose it, can't find it. And we ain't keen on being reminded about the film if it didn't hit. No, gotta lose it. Watch movies with my friends, bringing joy, that's the blueprint. So come on and let's do this. Leave pain behind us and relax your mind. Come watch a movie with Silas.